some staff for 2 and 3 aspirants, and I was one among them. He's a regular visiting faculty of Sitara and other institutes in Thompson Railway, including Nayar Gudavadla. Recently, he is faculty member of PFAM, which is one of the premier institute for accounts department of Indian Railways. That's about Sri A. Damodar Prasad, and it's over to Sri K. Damodar Prasad Garu to come in the session. Thank you all.
Thank you, Mr. Benhead. Good morning to all participants. I welcome to this session. When I heard the topic, it really fascinated me, because it is a journey.
Sir, please me Hindi ka bhi prayog kijiyega, sir.
Oh, sure. So, a journey, budget estimates, appropriation accounts, sunne ke baad mujhe bahut khush hua ki a journey is pure ke pure 2 saal ki journey, right from budget estimate stage and appropriation accounts stage tak. We are recollecting in this session all the 2 years journey. So I welcome once again to this particular session, and let us have our journey duly recollecting each and every stage or important event that we may come across or we will come across during this 2 years journey. So I will try to conclude within 1 hour 15 minutes or so. Last 15 minutes, let us have the interactive session so that we will be learning in the learning process is required. So straight away, I will be going into the subject. All of us, we knew that when we say budget estimates, it is the parliamentary financial control is one exercise that normally the control of parliament is exercised through the budget, because we all knew that the budget is presented in the parliament, then only the amount will be legally available for all the departments for spending. Because the money, whatever we earn, even though we meet our revenue expenditure and some part of our capital expenditure from our own finances, still the money, whatever we earn, it will not be available with us. It will go into consolidated fund. Yeah. So, therefore, the money which is required to be taken for our activities, we should have approval from Parliament. So that is how the parliamentary financial control is exercised by means of budget. Okay. Next, another important point is it is a management, because whatever activities we have, all those activities on revenue side, that is on day-to-day maintenance side, or on capital side, those activities though, we have to project them in financial terms. So when we physical activities, when we convert it to financial activities, and those financial activities will be reflected in the budget. So when you are controlling the budget, means you are controlling the about the essential feature of the budget. So, in a way, when you are reviewing the budget, we can say that you are reviewing the budget. In a timeline, which activity of the PhD in the form of fund, how much of all your work. Not only when financial terms, if you see, it is financial progress what will be seen. Similarly, it will be coupled with physical progress also. So that way it is very important in management to see whether an activity is
Japronics ka mangwaya nahi kharida hai na kal.
So whatever activities that were given, for which funds were given, so those activities that can be seen by reviewing the budget. One more important point is the financial control, whatever I said, it is secured through budget submission. That is okay. But in the budget also, there is voted part of expenditure. For that only, parliament is required. But there is another type of expenditure, for which vote of parliament is not required. For that, restrict say sanction limit. Restrict say sanction limit. Magar wo expenditure bhi hame consolidated fund of India se lete hai. Magar that is not voted, but we call it as a charged expenditure. So that charged expenditure and voted expenditure will be obtaining from by submitting the budget. You may be getting a doubt already. One of our sessions I explained that the vote of parliament and the charged expenditure, as far as railways is concerned, only the amount which is payable as a result of court decree say. जो पैसे हमें स्टाफ को देते हैं नए तो कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स को देते हैं दैट अमाउंट ओनली चार्ज एक्सपेंडिचर एज फार एज रेलवे एक्सपेंडिचर इज कंसर्न्ड इट डज नॉट गो फर्दर सो दिस इज वन अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज दैट दिस फाइनेंशियल कंट्रोल इज कंप्लीट ओनली व्हेन वी गिव अकाउंट बैक टू पार्लियामेंट सो दैट गिविंग बैक टू पार्लियामेंट इट विल बी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ appropriation accounts. So these appropriation accounts, they are subjected to audit, C&AG ka scrutiny hote hain, or Public Accounts Committee bhi examine karte hain. So when it is examined by Public Accounts Committee, you can say that we have submitted all our accounts, comparing hamara jo bhi expenditure ho chuke hain pure financial year ka, and how much we have spent and how much Parliament has given. But when I say Parliament has given, that means voted and charged also. Don't think that it is only confined to voted expenditure or voted part of budget. No. Appropriation, that is giving account back to Parliament, that will be both for voted and charged expenditure. Because after all, the charged expenditure is also charged on the consolidated fund of India. So therefore, we should have that charged expenditure also in appropriation accounts. So public accounts committees will be submitting these appropriation accounts. So this is all about introduction about budget. Why we should have because it is not only parliamentary control, it is a management tool. Okay. So now, how it has become a constitutional document? What are the constitutional provisions that are available? Let us see one by one. So as per Article 112, this is called estimated receipts and expenditure. This annual budget, it is called as estimated receipts and expenditure. In our code books as well as in the budget documents also, it is written as annual financial statement. So the annual financial statement, it is nothing but annual budget. It will be laid before both the houses of parliament. So that is that is requirement as per Article 1. Now, Parliament discusses the policies and allocations, whatever we have provided, and revenue expenditure, as already I told you, revenue expenditure as far as railways are concerned, we ourselves are varied. Even though now the railway budget is merged with the budget, we even now also we pay our expenditure from our revenues. Okay. But capital segment, I said partly from our internal sources, that is DRF. It is a charge on the revenue, and DF and capital fund or debt servicing fund. All these are created out of our surplus. If any surplus is there, then we will be creating, and the expenditure is met from. Not only that, and the rail, the ownership of railways being with Indian government, will be getting gross budgetary support. That is budgetary support in the form of capital, and in addition to that, whatever money they give for RRSK and other helpers. So both including all that will be called as gross budgetary support. So when gross budgetary support is also given, our capital segment of expenditure will be getting from that. Apart from that, when it is not commensurate with the expenditure requirements, fund requirements, then we are going in for market borrowings to IRFC. Mostly we will be utilizing for our rolling stock purposes. And apart from that, we also will be taking care of under EBR, extra budgetary resources. But please remember that this extra budgetary resources, wherever you find it in the document, that amount will not be subject to vote on money. It is not, even though it is indicated that for doing the particular work, EBR amount also is taken. But whatever money that is required to be taken for vote of parliament, with that money only will be considered and vote of parliament taken for that, excluding this EBR. Because the name itself indicates, gives an indication to you that it is extra budgetary resources. So therefore, the parliamentary control will not be there on that. Okay, so budget per se, it has got three elements. One is you have to give the figures of the BCA. So in the budget IPAS module, already last year figures, whatever we have submitted in the appropriation, those figures will appear as it is. So that will be the preceding year expenditure. Next, estimate of receipts and expenditure for it. This is the budget process. This is the budget exercise. Here, the estimate of receipts and expenditure. So, for the coming year, or we will call it as an ensuing year, so both receipts and expenditure will be giving for the next year. But at the same time, we will also review the current year requirements. So, for the current year, whatever budget was given, whether it is we can be within the fund given, or extra money is required, or the money given is the fund given is something extra. So if you want to surrender, you can surrender. So this stage simultaneously, RE, that is revised estimate for the current year, and budget estimate for the upcoming year, you will be preparing. And this is the budget review exercise now. Main important event. Okay. Then, as a government, so leave about railways. For railway, suppose the expenditure is likely to be more than our funds. Then, in that case, the proposal for meeting the requirements, additional requirements, or shortfall, whatever it is there, that has to be given. And how it will be given? What are the options that are left to railways is for increasing the fare and freight. So, to what extent we have to increase, and by increasing that, how much we will be getting? Is it balancing, and is there any surplus? And that surplus will meet our DF and CF or RRSK requirements or not? So, this is how we will see. So, the proposal for meeting the requirements will be done. So,
no.
when we are sufficient and there are no requirements for raising our face and pipe, then in that case, straight away, estimate of receipts and expenses. The budget is now second point is that as per Article 102, separate expenditure proposals charged on Consolidated Fund of India and met from it. That is only both we have to stick it. So when you are asking the fund in the form of demands for grants, you will have to know that what is charged expenditure and what is quoted expenditure. Around 99.9% of our expenditure is quoted expenditure, which requires vote of parliament. So whatever minuscule, minuscule is there, which is charged on consolidated, is charged expenditure. And as far as railways are concerned, as I already told, it is only amounts payable during the current year or during the ensuing year. As a result of court decree or court decree likely to come, you will assess and then proceed. And when the budget is communicated, you will be getting both voted and charged under various sub major heads or various minor heads and some sub heads and PU also. You will be getting both voted and charged. Similarly, for capital segment also, source-wise and planning-wise, voted and charged, both. And even credits also, beneath that, the credits also will be given. Whatever estimated credits are there, and finally, how much you have realized that anyhow you will be giving in the appropriation accounts. So, Article 112 says that your expenditure, you have to bifurcate into charged expenditure and voted expenditure. So, that is why we should know about the government accounting system, where these are the essentials of the government accounting system. So why capital, why revenue, why charged expenditure, why voted expenditure. So these are the essentials. Similarly, I will be letting you know about the commercial lines and strategic lines. So these are the essential requirements, essential ingredients of government accounting system, which generally we follow on railways being a government organization. Now, next one is Article 113. It says the charged expenditure shall not be subject to vote of parliament. So, we knew all these things, but now I am giving you the constitutional provisions. Next, 113.2, voted part of expenditure shall be submitted to Lok Sabha in the form of demands for grants. So, in the form of demands for grants, is in what format we have to give? So, it is the committee of estimates, they will decide in what format they require, and accordingly, we will be preparing the format. Already I told, last year figures we have to give, and current year requirements review we have to give, and ensuing year how much we require, that also simultaneously we have to give, and then this is what Article 13.2 says. So voted part should be submitted in the form of demand for grants. So after the budget of value budget with general budget, now we were given only single demand. So under single demand, various major heads on the seat side, major heads on expenditure side we have. So we will have to give our requirements or our audit estimates. We have to give our revenue segment expenditure. We have to give our major heads and sub major heads, minor heads, sub heads, PUs. Up till this, we have to give. Similarly, capital side, PUs, sorry, we have plan head wise, source wise, work wise, we have to provide. So these things. The civil grants. Whatever required under F loans and advances, whatever you require under other segments or sectors of I2K or I2L, whatever you require, that also they will come under civil grants, and you have to ask budget. So this is about demands for gas. The former demand for gas is where you and Lok Sabha has power to assent or refuse to assent or assent subject to reduction of specified amount. This all we knew, the adjournment motions, cut motions, so many things will be there. So that will be done. Next one is Article 133. No demand for grant shall be made except
the requirement.
So, whatever requirement is there, we will make it. And then the set asset will be taken and then presented to the parliament. So, this is Article 133. Then, one more important point is that whenever we all knew that the budget grant is a grant given based on our PE. But it is not only that at that stage, at another stage also, Parliament to judge the hand, those read time. So, the second stage, Parliament to that day, Parliament say, what's read the hand, go high, supplementary stage. Normally, RE protections when you give and wherever adjustments are required to be done among the zonal lightway, wo hone ke baad bhi budget jo bhi hamare ko aaye hain, if wo kam pade to, then if our expenditure we cannot control or we cannot postpone it, then in that case Parliament से फिर वो demand, वो demand और वो measure है, वो sub measure है,
नहीं carbon नहीं निकालना,
primary
carbon से
supplementary,
यहाँ पर ये वाला खत्म हो जाएगा, तो वो वहीं से उठा करके एक वो carbon के साथ वाला
Parliament again will consider and then they will view supplementary. But one important point which I want to tell you is that a supplementary grant हमारे regular RG के साथ दूसरे booklet, small booklet will come. A separate communication will come from the Labour Board and when we do our appropriation reports, we will have to take those figures which we got as a supplementary grant in that booklet and in that measure head, sub measure head or primary or plan head or source or work, where that supplementary grant was then how to add to the original grant one. So because this grant also has been the approval or vote of parliament. So this is ये तो दूसरी stage है, दूसरे grant है जो parliament से approval लेके vote of parliament लेके हमारे को आते हैं. So this supplementary estimate sanction of president need to be obtained not only under as per 133, because any demand if you want to give supplementary demand or even excess demand also, which we will be discussing. So even excess demand also with the parliament president approval only we have to bring it to the notice of parliament and then we have to obtain vote of parliament. So 115 is meant for supplementary estimate. Then excess demand. This is under Article 151. अगर पूरा साल हो चुके हैं एंड और फाइनल अकाउंट करंट हमें भिजवाया और वो भिजवाने के बाद फाइनल अकाउंट करंट से वो एक्चुअल एक्सपेंडिचर बनेगा, वो एक्चुअल एक्सपेंडिचर हमें पार्लियामेंट से जो भी आए हैं या क्या क्या आया है, बजरी ग्रांट आया है और बाद में सप्लीमेंट्री ग्रांट अगर आप मांगे तो सप्लीमेंट्री ग्रांट भी आ गया. सो आप ये दोनों के कंपेयर करके एक्चुअल एक्सपेंडिचर ये दोनों से कंपेयर करके वी हैव टू गिव एक्सप्लेनेशन इन फॉर्म ऑफ अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट्स. सो दीज अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट्स सर्टिफाइड बाय ऑडिट एंड बट द ग्रांट एज ए होल इफ यू हैव सर्व मोर देन व्हाट वाज गिवन अंडर वो प्लस लेस. वो प्लस लेस माने ओरिजिनल ग्रांट में और सप्लीमेंट्री ग्रांट में भी उससे उसके अलावा आपने स्पेंड किया, उसके ऊपर आपने स्पेंड किया, तो as per Article 112.1, because when you took the money, you do not. Do you have any power to take more money from consolidated fund of India? No. Who has got the power? It is only Parliament. As per Article 112, 113, 132, the demand has to be accepted by Parliament. So unless it is done. So that means when you incurred more, means you have unnecessarily took the burden of you took the burden that okay, Parliament will be giving. No, sometimes it may give or may not give. That is different. But do the excess expenditure of them, demand, pure demand. Not, I don't say that it is individually, no. Previously we used to have so many problems. Then our railway budget we used to present. This we will discuss later. But now you should know that any grant voted by Parliament after completion of 5 years is upon submission of the appropriation accounts, excess expenditure, if you are incurred to regularize a demand which was a demand of Parliament based behind or depending upon based on the recommendation of EAC and the scrutiny of audit, C&AG, that will be passed and that will be given as excess grant. Tab, jo bhi hame excess spent kiya, wo legally, they have been regularized. Till such time, we cannot say that they have been legally available. Only what is legally available? It is O, personal grant, and S, supplementary grant. These are the only two things that are legally available. If you incur any expenditure more than that, it is not legally available till the same is regularized under Article 151 of the Constitution. That excess grant, unless the Parliament gives, is not legalized. So it is the responsibility of the Parliament to give the regularization and of course action taken note anyhow from you to that, why that has happened, so that I'll let you know later. Okay. So this is as per the Constitution. Now having said this, now let us go into the Accounts Department. The compilation of budget is one of the functions of the Accounts Department. Now by this you will understand that we are not the budget authorities. The budget framing authorities are the executive. They project the requirements based on the nature of work they have, based on that is active, and on which they want to spend, that is object of expenditure. So they will project those. Similarly, on capital side, what are the works on hand and at what stage they are, and how much money they require for during the year. This will be the function of the secretary. Then you will be questioning, sir, what is the role of accounts? So the role of finance is that examine that they are as per the the provisions, they are based on the realistic estimates, based on the realistic data that is available as per previous years, or based on the, suppose something is more or worse, so what are the events that that is required, that led to the overspending. So we will be examining that. Then the compilation is what part. Okay. So, whatever rules and regulations, classic changes in accounts classification, if any are there, that also we will be doing that. That is our job. The second job is, I am taking from accounts code only, so the second job is assisting the management with the relevant reports. Of course, in IPAS, is readily available, and the financial data for management reporting, revenue allocation registers, box registers, the appropriations, budgetary control, expenditure control statements, all these things will be providing, and that is also finally, at the end of the financial year, giving the appropriation account, C&AG, for certification of the closure of the financial year. This is available in our accounts board. Then, what are the stages? Capital stages have
been. Sir, excuse me, sir, kindly mute the all participants, sir. Some noise are coming, sir.
Participants required. Please mute. So, our budget mein kya kya stages?
Sir, please submit.
So, the budget stages. What are they? Now we are going through the journey of budgets. Appropriation accounts. We will be learning each and every stage during this process. So, the budget stage, first stage is the budget preparation. So, budget preparation, how it should be done? Who has to do? Because I already intimated that the budget preparation is in the hands of budget officers, that is, executive. Our role is to ensure that they are not violating the rules and regulations and the changes in forms and classification is there, that accordingly that has been done, and any penalty is removed, then we are not asking fund, or any activity like steam is closed, then on that also we are not asking. So such things only will be looking and comparing the budget. And, the data is on a realistic basis because in the appropriation accounts there will be an extra K defects in budgeting and control over expenditure. Failures, there will be an audit, will be enumerating. It is our responsibility to ensure that the budget is prepared on the realistic data, on the realistic basis. Okay. Then, the next stage is enactment of budget. This enactment of budget, these stages also, different stages are there, I'll let you know. But this enactment of budget stage after 2017-18, our value budget has been merged with the general budget. This part is thank you. So, this enactment of budget activity almost is not there with us now. Previously, we used to do when separate budget is presented. Now, it is entirely the responsibility of the Ministry of Finance. Our role is limited to giving our requirements to Ministry of Finance. Once we give, the enactment of budget will be done by Ministry of Finance. Okay. Second, third stage is execution of this is most important. Because whatever, if the budget has been prepared by us and it has been approved by Parliament, and then budget has been given to us, so the execution we have to take as projected by us, as envisaged by us, as on the activities which were approved by Parliament. So that part, whatever problems we face, we have to hold on. Sometimes you will be jealous of Yehoga. Or expenditure come budget, then what should we do? Or we ask, the expenditure is both jada ho rahe, or budget jo bhi diya, both come. Kya karna? Expenditure control karna padta hai. Karna hai to, dusre jagah se paise lena padta hai. Funds lena padta hai. So, that we call it as very, very important tool in the hands of our executives. this great improvisation. To be activity high budget high, that activity from one activity to another activity, there is, if there are any expenditure both come high or budget come high, so kya karna. So the executive is given very powerful tool in this, within the set of the rules frame. Reappropriation rules are very clear, and accordingly they will come for finance conference and then we have to. So that reappropriation, wherever it is required to be done, if you are not doing, then it is also a mistake. Because somewhere, suppose under PU 32, expenditure is heavy, or PU 27, expenditure is less, then between PU 27 and 32, you can have reappropriation. Of course, it should be within the same demand, or the same demand means same grant. Same grant, there is same sub-major head, and some within the sub-heads, you can have. So, these kind of advices also from accounts officer, so that that is execution of budget. That is most important activity. Means without disturbing the parliament many a time within the given budget, how to do our activities very effectively. That there the strength lies. The strength lies for the organization, both on account of the responsibility lies both on accounts side as well as executives. From accounts side, you have to advise them, and from executive side, they will have to oppose the reappropriations at the appropriate time without exceeding. Suppose we should not allow exceeding the expenditure, exceeding the budget given, because now we are there to see that. That always we have to keep in mind. And finally, another stage is the appropriations. If I say okay, I said they took a high, or then we have to give back that account. Not yet. I mean, not yet. He said, Jada bhi ho chukhe hai. Then why it is? Then come ho chukhe hai. There are certain limits of within those limits. Did not explain. Otherwise, we have to explain. Then, now, what are these? Hamare budget. It is not just what I can say, it is not fixed budget. I can say it is a flexible budget. You will always, you can review the budget. And based on the expenditure incurred, you can review. If you don't require, you can surrender. If you require more, you can ask whether it is given or not given. That is a different issue, because the availability, that is most important. There are one or two stages after general budget advancing. We lost one stage, that is August review stage, B-499. Only revised estimate, budget estimate stage have. And one more stage is final modification stage. So the revised estimate stage or budget estimate stage, it has been advanced. Previously it used to be November or so. November or December, because the budget availability from 1st April is becoming difficult, so therefore it has been advanced to September. So therefore August review has been eliminated, and this REB, that is revised estimate for the current year, and budget estimate for this second ensuing year, simultaneously after fixing revised estimate, budget estimates also will be fixed. And then this revised estimate will help you reviewing the grant, whatever it is, whether it is required or something extra is required or something surrender, then all those things you can do at the revised estimate stage. And in budget estimate stage, once revised estimate is fixed, then revised estimate based on the next year, same parameters, if they are available, find whatever known excesses or known savings are there. So that always we have to build into the budget, revise estimate, then make it a budget estimate of the achievement. So once you do that, then this budget estimate is what you mentioned here, you are asking. And this revised estimate, you have already revisited your budget plan, and you will be asking revised estimate. You are asking revised estimate in the month of September. Now, this, when revised estimate is asked, generally the funds from all 17 general railways or production units, wherever it is required, normally the adjustment will be place and more cheap revision plan. Then this revision plan is sacrosanct for the rest of the community. Suppose in the month of January, the revision plan has been given. Then in that case, from January onwards, the revised estimate is sacrosanct. Till such time, the PG, the budget estimate, whatever you got earlier in the month of April, so that will be sacrosanct, and then you have to see that the expenditure is within the budget plan. How can you see that the expenditure is within the budget plan for the first 5 months? There is another system, the budget control systems are there that I will let you know. So this budget plan, when relevant is given, it will be in 2 parts. And part one is for entire Indian Railway as a whole, and part two is for individual railways. And each part will have major heads, sub major heads, minor heads, sub heads. And capital side, you will be having primary major heads, sub plan heads, and work wise, source wise. And for lump sum provisions will be given to the zonal railways. And in zonal railway, again, they will be giving some amount for the headquarters, and some amount even for lots of works in the divisions. So this is how the revised estimate and budget estimate is done. Second stage is when, based on the RE, if the total put together, if the grant is not sufficient, in such cases, we will be going for supplementary demands. So supplementary demand also you will give, and because of supplementary demand, you will be getting some grant for the current So this exercise is also for the current year. Then later on, before going into that last opportunity, what I would like to say is a supplementary demand without knowing ourselves will be asking. Visibly, we knew that yes, that expenditure cannot be foregone, or it is not being cut in, or it cannot be given taken to next year. So therefore, you will be asking. But how that supplementary plan, and if you spend, it is fine. But you have supplementary plan, and in the next stage, if you ask less, then also you will not be spared from criticism from audit, because even though when you ask the supplementary grant, it amounts that it has got more. So you will have to explain why you had the grant but you spent. Similarly, when you ask the grant under supplementary demand, and even then also when you explain, then also the audit will come. So why you could not take that excess also and for supplementary demand stage? So this is how it is a double-edged knife. When you ask, be double sure that you will spend. Your executive is willing to spend, and it has got liability. So therefore, ask. Otherwise, then no. Because sometimes we will be in the habit that okay, supplementary grant I ask, but in the final modification, next stage, in the final modification, it I reduced to the realistic. But not been taken into cognizance by CMDG or BAC. Even though you reduced, you may say that I have reduced it, but what is the use? But you took the time of parliament in passing the supplementary demand. Even then, you did spend. You took supplementary demand. Even that, you exceeded O plus S, you exceeded. Then you get banks. So this is most important. So supplementary demand, when you are asking, be very, very sure. Now, third opportunity that is given is the final modification stage. This final modification stage is only for expenditure. And on earnings, there is no final modification, only revision grant and budget grant. That is the only REB stage only available for earnings, but for expenditure, there is one more buffer behind, that is final modification. In February, we have compiled for 10 months ka actual suda, and 2 months ka andaz le sakte hain. And most importantly, please remember that in the last quarter, January to March, there will be a embargo on the expenditure limits. There are not more than 35% of the grant. But mostly, total grant, not more than 35% is only in January, February, March. Only 35% of the total grant, you should segregate them and distribute between these things. So, these are the important issues which you will be taking care of. And some adjustments always will be made in the month of March accounts. And in the month of March accounts, that also you have to keep in mind. And then, accordingly, final modification estimates. And when you make final modification, so when RE, when you are sent, you will be getting RG. When you send BE, the budget grant, after the voting of parliament and the sanction is taken, budget grant will be taken. And then, final modification stage of the current year, you will be getting Now, the budget preparation part is a constant obligation, and normally the ministry formulates the budget requirements. In our case, the ministry, so mid of October, so September, that is why September is fixed. So mid of October, the finance ministry, they have to discuss with them and consult the NITI Aayog about the annual plan, okay. Then the finance ministry consolidates and prepares the draft. And finance ministry approves the same in consultation with the PM. And then a brief note to government, to the cabinet, prepared by FM. And then the capital, normally the budgeting will be done from top to bottom. That is, the budget will be controlled at the top level in case of capital. And it will be fixed. So these are the activities which you should take. Then, accordingly, the budget formulations should be sent by the lower authorities. So this is because we knew that budget control, when limits are fixed, then it will be easy to control the expenses. No, you spend and we will give grant, then it will be a difficult situation. So that is why the capital always will be, policy will be decided by top level management, and estimates they will be going from bottom level. And revenue, because these are repairs and maintenance activities, day-to-day activities, so based on the past experience, last year, last 2 years, 3 years, expenditure, we will be taking revenue, expenditure projections, and then this normally from bottom level will be from this is how it will be done. So the essential feature is the revenue segment, capital segment, we have to get. That is the essential feature of the government budgeting system. So revenue receipt, other revenue receipt, and revenue expenditure. revenue receipt as far as railways are concerned. It's reject and revenue expenditure as far as railways are concerned. We knew all the sub-major head 012-11 is ordinary working expenses. And under capital segment, the van heads and source wise, that is capital expenditure. And capital receipts, normally, whatever sales, because of the sales in the capital side, whatever you get received, that will be capital receipt. And one more point is that the loans and advances, whatever recoveries we make from our staff on the construction side, that will be capital receipt. Then another essential feature is commercial lines bifurcating our expenditure and earnings, both on commercial lines as well as commercial lines money to the major head at 1001, 3002, capital 5000, miscellaneous expenditure 1001, miscellaneous capital commercial lines receipts and expenditure, revenue, expenditure, capital. Okay, strategic lines for North Railway, North Frontier Railway, NWR and WR, they will have to bifurcate their expenditure and receipts under 3003, 5000. So under this, so this mistake, 3003 and 5003. So this will give you the strategic lines, expenditure requirements. So this is how it will be prepared. And further, we have to bifurcate into sub major head, minor head, sub head. So sub head, it will indicate the activities. Then PU, object, on what you will be spending. So the budget, you have to present in this way only. And the budget after passing, you will get in that fashion. Then, already I told constitution requirement that voted and charged you have to do separately, 112 and 113 articles. So, then, the estimates committee says that it should be provided in the form of events plans. This is how these are the essential features of the budget. So the RE, the revised estimate, already I told you that it starts in the process in month of September. So this is prepared based on the earnings and expenditure trends for first 5 months. So what are they? April to August. So in the September, we will be compiling them. All known facts will be taken into consideration. And in the next 7 months, what are the projections that are likely to take place? That also we will take into account. And then the ordinary working expenses will be prepared for the RE, revised estimate, and budget estimates. Based on the RE, how much extra percentage we can do, or what are the extra features that are there in the next coming year, or the feature which is available in the current year, which will not be there in the next year. Suppose some Mela is there current year, earnings may go up, but next year earnings may not be to that extent. So that is why all those things consider, and then we will be fixed. So this is how it is. And any changes in the accounts classification that are circulated, immediately we have to bring it to. Suppose previously some tax maybe now GST. So separate PUs work. So those PUs we have to consider, and then we have to change our projection pattern and accordingly we have to. Suppose some plan heads were now removed, 37 was removed. So we have to remove that expenditure, and whatever it is required, we the 36 only, that is other electrical works we have to bring that. This is how it should be done. And in what segment, the expenditure, the budget process, it will be for works in progress. Whatever we ask, it will be for works in progress. And based on the works program sent by each railway separately, board will finalize new works and outlay in consultation with Ministry of Finance and the after the annual outlay will be fixed, and that will be the ceiling limit, and within that, the works program, new works, what are the things that are to be incorporated. Each individual directory will tell you, and then accordingly within the ceiling limits for annual outlay, based on the sources, different sources, the annual outlay will be fixed and the works selected will go into new works. But works in progress, all the works for which works in progress are there. So the amount, how much money we have to keep for works in progress, and it is within the realm of Ministry of Railways, and they will decide, and accordingly, in some cases you must have observed that one finance minister, one railway minister said that no new funds. That means entire money that is available under capital segment or DRF, DF, or DF capital fund. So all DSF or RRSK, everything it is given to funds. So how it should be given and what are the parameters is left to the consent scheme. So they will be doing that. The revenue budget, when we are making it, they got tax revenue. Normally, how much tax that is collected will be collected. That will be formed under tax revenue. But as far as railway receipts are concerned, revenue receipts are concerned, it will come under non-tax revenue. That is why the traffic warnings X, Y, Z, these will be forming part of non-tax revenue. Railways. That is why our budget requirements, our revenue receipts, they will not be subject to vote of money. That our finance bill is not passed. Whereas other taxes, whatever they want to enhance, whatever changes that they want to brought in. So you may have observed that during the budget process, finance bill will be introduced. So as per that only, the taxes will be paid. But the railway earnings, they are not non-tax revenue. They are not tax revenues. They are non-tax revenues. Okay. Then whatever loans and recovery, whatever loans, F loans and advances, whatever we have given to our employees, and from them, whatever we are recovering in budgeting, that will form under revenue receipt. Then our revenue expenditure, all payments, that is the civil grants, whatever loans and advances, what we are giving employees, it will be revenue expenditure, and pay allowances, repairs and maintenance activity, operating, staff amenities, pensions, appropriations. By this time, you will be understanding that as to the demand for tanks are now submitted heads, all those things, even including civil tanks. So this will form the revenue expenditure of the budget. Okay. Now capital budget, capital receipts, as I already told, for construction staff, whatever civil grants what we have given, and if you recover, that amount will form capital receipts. Then any receipts, sales, because of sales, if you are getting any receipt, then you will be getting that capital, that is receipt of capital. Call them as receipt of capital, and you will be capital receipt. Then capital expenditure. This capital expenditure, again, the pay and allowances of the capital construction staff, whatever payments you are making, the grants, that will be loans and advances, and plan and expenditure, and source-wise. Then for works in progress, new works. Then for itemized works and lumps of works. So this is how it will be done. So this capital, this is all about capital budget. So capital budget, the upper limit is annual plan. That annual plan, funds availability is annual plan fixed. Then requirement is for week project. Jobi Hamein Mangte, that is requirement. Jobi funds high, that is annual plan. So, kaha kaha se aa rahe? So, how much we are earning? How much is cross budgetary support that is given by Government of India, Finance Ministry? How much we are going to have under our internal resources, our earnings? Earnings minus our expenditure. Then, the surplus, how much it will be here? So, DF, CF, how many, what type of box we can protect, to what extent we can protect, that also. So once this plan is made up, and then board approval is taken, and then the clearance from NITI, wherever for works cost more than 5 crores or so, taking and then first this annual plan and requirements are available. Then first individual directions, they are finalized the works. Then for works in progress, how much it is. You give the details and budget directly, you prepare the budget. And these projections, they will be available in works, missionary, rolling stock program, popularly known as big. So under the capital segment, normally, it will be under major head 5002 and 5003. 5002 is commercial lines, 5003 for commercial lines. So those railways, four railways, they have to project at 5003. That will be capital segment. And the BE, the budget estimate, we did not ask, and based on the works programs sent after scrutiny by individual railway, depending upon the money that is available on the various sources and plan heads, the outlay board will fix the budget. Then the works are approved, new lines, gauge conversion, doubling, plan heads, as per the rules of allocation. Then there will be inventory heads will be there. So those inventory heads are WMS stores and revenue also will be there. So the interlink issues within the demand, they will be shown as direct entries, and between stores and WMS there will be contra entries. That is, they will appear once in one budget, in one inventory budget as debit, and same amount will be shown as a credit in another budget. So these are all the things which we are looking at. And the revenue side under PU27, whatever withdrawals, the revenue side, whatever we are proposing, that figure also will be stores, and stores will consider for the purchase budget, what they project, that also we will keep it. So these are the things we are looking at, and this capital segment is done. And it will be plan head wise and source wise. And when we get budget, that also plan head wise, source wise, it will be received. And in IPAS, we have to project, we can pass, we can project plan head wise, source wise. If you give data, and automatically the summary will be getting, or we can feed the data directly. Also. So this is what it was given. Now, whatever requirements are there, when you capture, so you have to provide it. I pass only budget module and then budget. So this is how it is done. And credits and charge expenditure also we have to check. And if due record is taken, yes, budget officers, they will take the process of expenditure and commitments. Accordingly, they will be budget. And most importantly, from RVNL, whatever works that are there. So for them, if they are being executed at zonal railway, they have to ask the requirement of funds from RVNL, and then we should include in our budget, in our budget, and debits when they are accepted. Then when RG is communicated, the same will be fed into the system. That will be an RI pass, work-wise, really matching with the summary, whatever. But the budget, whatever we get, so we should match whatever we enter into the system, both should tally. Nothing less. This is the responsibility of the executive departments as well as the cost department also. So internal correlation is that always we have to ensure that stores and WMS, direct entries and contra entries always will see, and then we submit or IMAS. Okay. Another thing is earnings. Earnings also, because already I told you, the earnings are most important because the annual outlay fixing the earnings also they play a very important role. So, depending upon the cash plan, how much we get, how much we got in the first 5 months, and then corresponding period, how much, and in the projection periods, how much we are like last year, how much we are, now, how much we are. So these are the things we will be considering, class-wise, commodity-wise, and then we will be projecting those earnings for passengers and freight traffic, and other coaching earnings, last year actuals will be taking. So these other coaching earnings are possible, between postal and other, then anticipated traffic plan, whatever it is there, and monthly originating earnings, passenger goods, other coaching traffic, has to be furnished. And certain annexures are there, those annexures, even even on the revenue side or capital side, they start with W, revenue side they start with R, and earnings start with E. So whatever annexes are there, you have to give, but these things can be given after some time. But a summary of what working expenses and earnings, you should go to that with the approval of general manager. So, then similarly, civil estimates also we have to make, the loans and advances we have to make, and other projections, the interest and other obligations, etc. we have to make under each of the sectors, I to M, we have to furnish, and interest on PF, realistically, of course, now because of modernization, to do. So these civil estimates also project, and then we'll be hitting civil rates. Okay. Now, as I said, the budget enact, so this is the budget preparation side you have completed, and budget enactment. In the budget enactment, as I already told, this entire step, these, all these steps we have given to. Now they are resting with the finance ministry. Now, what are they? Presentation of budget in the form of event for grants to the parliament, then discussion, that is calling attention motions or cut motions, adjournment motions or rising questions, all these things will be done, and then the voting will be taking place. Then the appropriation bill will be introduced to the Lok Sabha, and then after that the budget is passed. As I said, finance bill, it is only limited to taxes, tax revenue, how it should be, to bridge the gap, they will be preparing. And for us, we, because our earnings are not are coming under non-tax revenue, it is not going to be part. So now what an account, only when mostly election years, to facilitate the new government to have its own policies, only for a limited extent of 2 months or 4 months or 6 months. How many months that requirement is there, what an account will be prepared, and when new government takes place, again we will be setting the requirements, and then the budget, full-fledged budget. So this is how. Then the budget execution, already I told, the budget execution is most important stage. So based on the budget passed by parliament and president sanction obtained from the appropriations, then the budget order will be. The budget order is the document through which the budget is completed. So in the budget order, whatever amounts that are completed, those amounts will be known as budget allotments. The budget allotments, these are meant for budget reviews only. They are not spent, they are not meant for spending. For spending, slightly different levels will be given. These are spending limits. So these spending limits are the limits where the executive can spend, and our budget reviews also we will make on spending limits. And the spending limit is the upper limit of which you can allow spending. This is during budget execution. This is another. Then, as far as revenue budget is concerned, the budget, entire budget cannot be spent in 1 year, unlike in planned expenditure. So the entire budget will be bifurcated, proportionate budget based on the last 3 years actuals, the proportionate budget allotment, that is total budget given, will be bifurcated into month-wise ceilings. So that month-wise ceiling, called them as proportionate budget allotment, and we should ensure, being a constituent, we should ensure that no extra expenditure is incurred beyond the proportionate budget allotment in any particular month. So this is how the budget control will be exercised. This we will discuss next session, next slides. Then the budget order, as far as works segment is concerned, it will be given plan advisor source wise, and this will be given to the BHODs and BHODs. Whereas the proportionate budget allotment and the revenue budget allotment will be done by BFO office based on the BE projections given by this. The same proportion will be distributed. Then another important point is that already I told, where money is available, and if it is not required, then you can reappropriate, subject to there are certain conditions are there. So within those conditions, you are always at liberty to reappropriate. When availability is there, there is when requirement is there for reappropriations, you can do absolutely no issue. But the important point is the reappropriations cannot be done after financial year is over. Within the financial year only you can. Next, number two, no reappropriation you should permit in vote on account stage. The 2 months, 4 months or 6 months, wherever vote on account is there, you should not allow any vote on account. Any reappropriation. That's all. Then the budget distribution, as I already told, the revenue budget will be distributed by BFA and capital segment for new works and works in progress will be distributed now. For big book items, it will be coming in the big book for lump sum works, the HOD and the DRM, that is coordinating that division of the district. So that it will be done, and they will be telling those things to the accounts department. Our responsibility is to see that the total ceilings that is communicated in the form of budget order, that is not exceeded. So, if you do that, that is enough. And controller expenditure, you can do with reference to those items. Okay. Now, these are, I did not tell, so it is around September. All target dates for REBE is in September, we have to complete. Now, budget or expenditure control tools, I will stop here. I will not go because budget expenditure controls also quickly will complete the process and then we will go for appropriation. So the budget or expenditure control tools mainly is fixing this period within which we have to spend. Then fixing the proportionate budget allotment every month. Then the appropriations is also a budgetary control mechanism and expenditure control. Expenditure control, around 70% of our expenditure is cash. So, exchequer control is, if you control, it is said that 70% of the budget is. So, exchequer control. Then, expenditure control, always it will be financial scrutiny of estimates. Miscellaneous expenditure proposals and proposal for creation or extension of post, internal check of the clients. So, all these will come under expenditure. And the other tools that are available for budget expenditure is revenue allocation register, where comparison is there for the budget abstract wise, minor head, sub head, and then funds as well as in comparison with actual expenditure and excess or saving. Everything will be available. And it is a management tool where they can view where under which activity work is not sorry the activity is not progressing well, where low booking is there or where excess booking is there, where you have to ask more. And works register, it is a two-pronged approach will be there, because with reference to estimate and with reference to the allotment, the actual expenditure is compared, and wherever you require more funds, you can ask the executive to go for the appropriation or seek more funds in the budget review stages, or if it is going beyond the estimation stage, then you can alert the executive to go for revised estimate. Then financial review, through financial review, you will be putting up to DRM and general manager at journal level so that they will know which work it is progressing, whether it is progressing as they envisaged or anything to be done. So that will give in the financial review, they will have both financial progress as well as fiscal progress. Okay. Then later on, the expenditure after financial year is over, audit will examine our appropriation accounts and PAC will scrutinize our appropriation accounts. So annual budget, that is most important budget, because at top level itself we will stop. Then further expenditure anyhow. So that is why annual budget is one important. And budgetary proportional budget allotment. This will facilitate the budgetary control. Then the expenditure limits also, they are prescribed in MSOP, SOP, and accordingly they will be spending them. Then the control works, the control of works expenditure. This is works register is one important tool where every month comparison can be made. Then another one is the progress report of financial. As I said, physical progress as well as financial progress will be there. So that will be seen by both executive and remedial actions that can be taken. Then control of revenue expenditure, already proportion budget allotment based on the past actuals, already I told. Then you will also have revenue allocation register, the same purpose works register does. Here our revenue allocation register also, it will be compared with the grant actual expenditure, and it will facilitate the meaningful comparison, and the PHODs, they can take remedial action and they can take up with the executive where the failure is there. That also will keep. Then revenue expenditure, monthly financial review, normally at the regional level and at the zonal level, in one statements, that is revenue, earnings, revenue expenditure and capital expenditure, and finally operating ratio, working out and putting up to general manager or DRM. So this is how it will be done. Then operating ratio in division normally is not calculated, it is not calculable also. So there they will, we will be working out in the division EI, performance efficiency index. So that is how it will be done. Then reappropriation, as I said, it is very powerful executive tool for at the executive level to ensure flow of funds, where funds are available, where funds are not available, and within the framework that can be done. Then expenditure control, it is part of budgetary control, because 70% of the budget is cash. So once you control the cash, and the budget can be controlled 70%. So that is why exchequer control is introduced. Then once all these stages, right from budget preparation, budget estimate stage, till the final account current is done. So this entire process, it will be 10 months. Sorry, around 22 months process. So once this 22 months process is done, last 2 months of 2 years, now 22 months we have completed, only last 2 months. So these 2 months, it is appropriation. From June or July to September, these few months will be concentrating on appropriation accounts, that is giving reporting back to complete the parliamentary control. Will be giving these accounts back to Parliament after scrutiny by Public Accounts Committee. So this will be done both for voted and charged. That means as given in the Parliament, the budget grant will be so much detail will be given. So this appropriation account, most important activity is approval of excess grant, regularizing the excess expenditure. That is most important. Another one is parliamentary control, completion of parliamentary control. We took grant from them and we are accounting. That is fine. Second important point is that approval, taking approval for the excess amount which we have spent. So we will be comparing the actual expenditure with grant voted by Parliament or restriction voted less charge. Okay. Then after financial year is closed, then only we will be doing the final account current. Detailed program it will be given by board, and we will be strictly adhering to the whatever statements are there, and we will be submitting to CNDG for certification. After certification, BAC will scrutinize. So this is in form 403. Minor headwise we will be giving, and whatever excesses or savings are there, we will be giving explanation. And then for capital segment, same proforma but slight modification. Workwise we will be giving. There are four segments: capital, revenue funds, safety fund, RRSK, then advice will be given. And work-wise, for the criteria, whatever criteria is fixed, only within that criteria we have to explain. So this is how the appropriation accounts are prepared. So this is the grant. Slight, with slight modification, work-wise will be given for capital structure. Now let us go through quickly how excess grant is generated and what is that we have to say. For example, all of you, you are aware that 03-200, it is financial management, general superintendents and services. I just took small portion, but this you will understand. Once you understand this, you will understand the entire demand as a whole. For railway, suppose 83 or 84 is given. So for entire demand, if any excess is there, what should be done? That I will discuss now. So now you try to understand under a particular financial management, minor head 200, 03, abstract, or some other head 01. Now last year actuals are 80. Okay. Now PE, we ask 90. In anticipating some more extra expenditure. But the current PG was given 5. Okay. Now, current year, now the immediate budget review stage is RE. So in RE, normally in IPAS, automatically based on our first 5 months expenditure, it will give 3 options. So you can choose either one of them or you can enter whatever you feel, yes you can. So say for example, for me, first 5 months expenditure is 40 and corresponding period of the previous year 30 and projections for 7 months I made it 80. So total it is coming to me 120. So IPAS it is giving 90, 100, 110. So I took that new recruitment set, new activities, etc. So RE we may be fixing at 100. So and once I fix this 100, then I will be taking care of the next year requirements also, and PE I have fixed 120 because some more new recruitments will be there or new activity is coming, so therefore I have fixed 120. So now last year actual is 80, PE 90, PG 85 given, RE we have asked 100, but RG given is 85. So that means at the same PG level they have given. So now RG when it is given, and when RE we asked, supplementary grant also I asked, presume that, I asked 5, and supplementary grant was also given 5. Now under this only given. So current year financial modification, the month of February I have to give, so first 10 months actuals and 2 months projections I will take, and then I asked 85. So I restricted my expenditure to PG level. Now the final grant was given as 80. Finally, final grant was given less than the BG that was given. Now what should we do? Now current financial year actual is landed me at 110. Because of my laxity in the last 2 months or whatever it may be, my actual, I asked in the month of February, I asked 85 and given 80, but my expenditure all of a sudden it has gone to 10. Now for this, we have to give the appropriation. Now from budget estimate stage, now we are coming to the appropriation stage. Now let us see again. Budget grant given 85, RG given 85, supplementary grant 5 what was given. That means the parliament approval is available for 85 and 5. Total 90 parliament approval. Then final grant was given 80, that is distribution. I got 80, but I landed in 110. Now, what would be my appropriation account for some major head 01 under minor head 200? Let us see. The column 1, 85, original grant and supplementary grant. This also parliament approval is there, 5. And final grant distribution was given 80. And my actual expenditure is 110. So, surplus or shortfall will be AE minus FG. That is 110 minus 80. Okay, but while giving explanation, I should give actual expenditure minus what was voted by parliament or sanctioned by this. So this is voted part, so 85 plus 5, 90. So 110 minus 90, so it is 20. So for 20 rupees, I have to give explanation this is minor head, so sub head wise 210 accounts office, 220 cash and pay office, 230 EDPM, like that. I have to explain where is excess and where is saving, and that sum total of the excess and saving we should tally with totally. And why it is excess? Object of expenditure also I should say, increase in paid allowances or increase in purchases, like that I have to say. Now this is all about money, but this will not be, this will be surplus or shortfall, but for the demand as a whole. Now all some major heads, all major heads, and all major heads put together, major head 1001, 1002, 1003, 3001, 3002, 3003, 5002, 5003, all put together, how much our client was given, and how much that expenditure we required. And if that expenditure is more, then it will become excess. That excess is not covered by parliament. Legally, it is not available. We have taken that in our hands. Now we have to explain why. Because as per Article 112, it requires parliament. But we have taken, so we, that need to be referenced. So who will certify? That will be certified by public accounts committee. I will skip all these things already I told. So this also I'll skip. So, as per Article 151 of that excess, whatever, all put together, demand as a whole, for 83 or 84, how much here is? That is what I want to say is that one benefit which we got after merger of our railway budget is because we were given single demand. From then onwards, there is no excess demand for us. And otherwise, earlier I saw the recommendations of the PAC, scathing attack will be there under each of the grants, because we have got 16 grants. For each of the grants, somewhere excess is there. Railway as a whole, then they will be attacking the internal mechanism systems, controlling systems are not in place. So many things they use. Now, because of one demand, the same is not necessary. But if excess grant is there, what normally we do? So this will be certified. Okay. Then they are referred to PAC. Then Article 115, 1B stipulates that money spent in any, sorry, 151 actually, it should be, president has to ask that demand for such excess should be presented with the House of Lords. Then this regularization, concerned ministry shall furnish the explanatory note. Why that excess has it? We have to give. Then, as recommended by PSC and Government of India, initiates necessary action to get the excess expenditure regularized as per Article 151. This is how the excess grant regulation. I took 1 year where our railway has failed miserably. So, that year, that is needless to say, that it is prior to my merging railway budget, merging with the budget, 490 crores excess expenditure was there. All demands put together. There are at least 4 to 5 demands, that has 12 demands, where this excess has come. So in this lion's share is under 300 crores under plan number 14 of operation funds. Okay, normally we have it. So this, again, in our explanatory note, because we have to give to PSC, so in that we have pointed out that there is a misclassification of 6.16 crores also under Annex J, already have pointed out. So that also we took, and then the total we have come to 497 crores. So these 497 crores, furnished reason for each grant, and the PSC funded for access, despite an increase of the supplementary grant, they said in one particular case, we obtained supplementary grant, there also we have it. recurring excess expenditure, because it's at number 14, always excess expenditure, then persistent excess excess that's the appropriation. Okay. Nice, and then they comment, and then recommend that 497 be recognized. Then the excess demand will be presented in the parliament, and then that will be recognized. This is how. So I said 2 years, 2 years from budget estimates to appropriation account stage, September 19 to September 21. That is 1 year budget, 2020-21, starts from September 19 and ends with the appropriation accounts. This is the journey of 2 years. So I request the participants, if you got any doubt, you can ask me. Aisha Garu, you can unmute them.
Yes, sir. All are unmuted, sir. Oh.
Dear participants, you can,
okay.
You can ask.
Oh, yes, sir. Your class was khatam. Go my class, can
I? Because of time, I have to. Sometimes I have to pass through. Please. Excuse me for that. Any questions are there? Please ask.
Please check the chat box, sir. One or two queries is there. What is online?
Where I have to see nice regular?
Chat, sir. See, check the box.
Chat.
One query is what is outlay, and another
query
is what is supplemented
debt. First one is what is
outlay. Outlay.
Right. Another one is
What is supplemented
debt? I mean yes,
what is supplemented debt?
Okay, right. Thank you. Supplementary grant is. I will answer the latter one. We have projected our RE requirements. Previously, the supplementary grant we used to take after August review is completed. Now, August review is not there. So, based on RE, if all railway projections are taken and the sum total of the projections, if they are exceeding the grant that was already given, then in that case, and that expenditure, if we could not take to other year, and we have to spend in this year only, and that extra grant is required, then in that case, normally we will be asking the railway board, will make out a case for supplementary grant, taking the compilation, the grant, the source or plan head, or the sub-major head, sub-head and PU, all these things they will take into account. And then they go for supplementary grant, and during the budget session, the supplementary grant for the current year also will be taken, and then that will be communicated separately. It is not, it will not be there in the budget grant that was communicated earlier through budget only. Supplementary grant separately, small booklet will be there that will be given, and when you are preparing the appropriation accounts for O, you have to take that supplementary grant also into the account, and total expenditure you have to explain vis-a-vis O plus S you have to explain. But where the audit will point out is when you have asked a supplementary grant and you are not spent, entire supplementary grant was left. Suppose 5 crores I have taken, 5 crores I have kept it as is, then they will come under scaling. Or I have taken supplementary grant, even then also I have exceeded. In my case, I have exceeded 85 plus 5, but I finally at 110. That means the supplementary grant which I assessed is not coming. So these are the things which we have to take into account. As you said, first one is outlay. Yeah, right. Actually, outlay is the amount spent on capital expenditure, that is works expenditure side. All amount that was spent on capital, we call it as capital outlay. Yesterday, you may have learned about this closing entries. So, all the capital ledgers, they will be closer to capital outlay. That means how much during the year you have spent on capital or works expenditure, how much you have spent. That is capital outlay. Whereas, this is different from annual outlay. Annual outlay is the amount of the outlay fixed in consultation with Niti Aayog and discussion with Ministry of Finance. Finally, how much we have with us for capex expenditure, how much money we have, that is fund availability, that is capital, that is annual outlay. Whereas capital outlay means how much amount we have spent. After closing the ledgers, we will be closing the ledgers to capital outlay. So, how much you have spent? That is capital outlay. Annual outlay is fund available. Yeah. Any other question?
Earnings are coming under non-tax revenue, then what is the tax revenue of Railway?
Income tax. Income tax, whatever we collect from contractors and from our employees and officers, that is the tax revenue. In our account current also, under 0021 or so, major head is there. So there we will be collecting them and then in income tax.
I have a question, sir. So during budget, sir, during budget allocation, sir, when there is an, if there is an excess, is it getting reallocated, sir? Between is there any provision for reallocation, sir?
Then reappropriation.
Reappropriation.
As far as suppose I take your question as pertaining to revenue expenditure. Suppose you incurred expenditure more than the demand, more than the grant that was given under a particular abstract. Let me call it as a sub-major head, or let me call it as a sub-head also. Up till sub-head, the budget is given. So there, if you enhance, increase your booking of expenditure more than that, normally it will happen in non-controllable expenditure. Controllable be used, anyhow you will be controlling, absolutely no issue. But there are non-controllable be used because like pay and certain allowances you will not control. So there the expenditure is likely to increase because of recruitments or whatever it may be. So in such cases, if it happens, you can always ask your division or unit people to seek reappropriation from other divisions. So for that, you within your division or within your unit budget, if you are able to do, absolutely no issue. So they will come for finance concurrence. You give finance concurrence, and then that excess expenditure, it is offset with the reappropriation. But if you are not in a position to reappropriate within the grant, within among the subheads, you can always reappropriate. If it is not possible, then you will advise your branch officer to asked reappropriation from PHOD, because for PHOD we will be giving the revenue allocation register as a whole in railway, that is your zonal railway as a whole will be giving. So he will be knowing where less expenditure is there and where he can take out and then give it to your unit. So from that DRM he will take his consent and then to your division he can give, absolutely no issue, and the proposal will come in headquarters and we will agree to that. This is one. Similarly, in case of land heads also, land head most importantly, it is the responsibility lies with just like revenue, that also lies with your branch officer. Our responsibility as far as the accounts department is concerned, we have to tell him, see, you can do reappropriations from so-and-so work to so-and-so work within the same plan head. Different works you can always do. So that always, you send the proposal for reappropriation. Once you get that sanction, you can incur. But many a time, what I observe is, they send the proposal and finance concurrence will not be given and sanction also will not come. Before that, they incur expenses. But that is, don't allow such things. Normally, it should not happen. First, let them reappropriate, then you can incur expenditure. That is the best financial discipline which we have to inculcate among the budget officers. And revenue side, you know, every year, whenever they give the budget order or spending limit, they will tell these are the PUs where the reappropriation is permitted. PU 27, PU 28, PU 32, you can reappropriate. So those reappropriations, wherever you find that yes, there is some excess expenditure and there is less expenditure, and you can reappropriate, always, even though you send the RER to them, it is advisable from a accounts point of view, advise them, and they feel very happy. And from audit side also, even though there is a possibility for a reappropriation, they have not done. So that comment you can avoid. Please.
Sir, is excess grant or supplement that both are same, sir? Sir, is excess grant or fund supplementary grant, both are same or any different?
No, no. Thank you. Thank you for asking me this question. Supplementary grant is during the process, during budget process. That means during budget execution process, during the financial year, based on the RE, if total requirements of all railways, they go beyond the grant that was given, then Railway Board will go and ask Finance Ministry to propose supplementary grant. Under those, under that abstract, and under that subhead, and under that particular, they will be asking. Okay. Then Finance Ministry, they will come, not only railway side, other ministries also, they propose supplementary demand. So that supplementary demand, it will be processed under Article 115, and then the grant, what of Parliament will be taken, and then that grant separately in the month of January or February, in the form of a small booklet. You may go to your budget section, they will show you. Small booklet will be there for each railway, for each plan head, source, or abstract, or subhead, and PU, where this expenditure, the supplementary grant was given. So, as and when it is received, at the time of appropriation accounts preparation, what I will be doing is, I will be taking this booklet, and for say for example, Southern Railway. So, when I am doing Southern Railway, so there, for original grant, any supplementary grants are there. Say for example, sub-major head 01, any supplementary grant is there. If it is there, I will add under that minor head and under that particular grant as well as supplementary grant. So supplementary grant is a grant which based on the RE projected by us, Railway Board consolidates, and then if they not find out the means to give grant, then ask Finance Ministry to give supplementary grant. Go for parliamentary approval. So they take for parliamentary approval and then they come and they give the grant. So that is supplementary. During the year it will be done. But there is excess grant means after closure of the financial year. The financial year is closed. Final account current has been spent, sent, and then you are preparing the appropriation accounts. And all the appropriation accounts we have prepared and consolidated appropriation account at Railway Board level, it has been done there. If all major heads put together, all major heads expenditure put together, the expenditure is more than the grant, then that will be the excess grant. That means for that only we have taken our law into our hand. So that has to be recognized under Article 151. So that recognition will take place. And that grant which is communicated after closure of the financial year, as a result of excess being identified, shown, certified by CNAG and PAC, that grant is called excess grant. Excess grant is after year is over and after closure of the financial year, after year is over, and excess as certified by CNAG and PAC, if Parliament gives the grant, that grant to cover the excess, that is called excess grant. Hope I am clear. Yeah. Any other?
सर अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट में इतना अमाउंट एक्सेस होने के बाद उसमें जस्टिफिकेशन देना पड़ता है कैपिटल का कितना एक्सेस हो जाएगा तो
थैंक यू हियर इन अप्रोप्रिएशन अकाउंट्स नॉर्मली देयर आर इन मई मंथ इन दिस लास्ट मंथ ओनली 7th मई देयर इज वन सर्कुलर गिवन द लिमिट्स हैव बीन रिवाइज्ड दैट इज 5% और 500 लाख 10% और 100 लाख. So likewise, certain limits were given. So as far as those limits, if we are within those limits, you need not give explanation. Even appropriation accounts letter also, it clearly says, if you, the variation is within these limits, you need not explain. But a small amount, if compiled at railway level, Indian railway level, if it is going to be significant, what they are asking is better you give the reason so that the railway board level they will can compile the reason and then submit it to PAC, okay, or CNAG. So as far as your question is concerned, revenue expenditure and works expenditure, there are certain limits were given, that is 10% or 500 lakhs, 5% or 500 lakhs, 10% or 100 lakhs, there is limits are given. As if we, our expenditure is within these limits, we need not give explanation.
Thank you, sir.
But if the excess is beyond these limits, then you need to give explanation. But at the same time, Railway Board is requesting Zonal Railways, even though the amount is small, trivial, better you give so that when consolidation takes place, if it is going beyond these limits, then Railway Board will be having an answer due to CNAG. That is why, even though the limit is less than the excess is less than the limits given, we always try to give explanation.
Sir, in both cases, sir, excess or saving both, no, sir. Excess and saving in both cases.
Yes. Wherever, please remember one thing. Whenever it is said variation, it means it is plus and minus, excess and savings. Yes, you are right.
Sir, one question.
Yes, please.
Sir, what is appropriation to pension fund?
normally this is appropriation to pension fund and appropriation to DRF, depreciation reserve fund. These two are meant for retired assets only. These two meant for retired assets only, because DRF is meant for replacement and pension fund is for retirees. You have to make payment. So normally this is done, the budgeting will be done under estimate demand number 14. Now sub major head 12. So late it will be done. Now what will be the basis? Who will do this? As far as pension fund is concerned, the budgeting will be done by our account service. From our pension section or settlement section, they will give these things. Now what will be the basis for them? Number of retirees. Number of the amount which we are accepting the debit from pension paying agencies like post offices or majority public sector banks, how much every month we are accepting and how much amount we are spending, that we normally in our railway parlance we call it as pension outgo. So this pension outgo and retirements and attritions, whatever it will be there, and then that will make us to fix the appropriation, how much it will be done. So it will be sent, and then railway board it consolidates, and demand number 14 that will be finalized there. But surprisingly, the expenditure, if you look at sub major head 11, that means that's 12 demand number 13. The expenditure always will be very, very close, of some 100 crores or so. Where is this 48,000 crores or 50,000 crores which we are projecting? And why is this expenditure only available? That means whatever demand, whatever projection or whatever budget we got, automatically when you prepare your JV, whenever you prepare your CO7 in pension section, passing settlement benefits, or when your expenditure is JV to JV, when you are looking for the debits, what you received from the debit scrolls, whatever you receive. So when you do that, then whatever amount you are taking, you are booking, automatically it will be taken, and then JV will be prepared from appropriation, that is sub major head 12 to sub major head 11 automatically. That is why this will happen only under pension, but it will not happen under DRF. Automatic taking it will not happen, because appropriation to fund, it will be there for DRF under booking will be done under sub major head 5002 or 5003 DRF. This adjustment will not take place. The adjustment of pension fund will take place under living from submitter demand number 13, demand number 14. From demand number 14, automatically the amount. That is why, to that extent, the amount will get nullified. And net budgeting, whatever we do in government accounting, that will not show you. But actually, pension outgo, that is appropriation fund, made based on the attritions, pension fund payments to the year, and the amount which you are you are incurring or allocating or booking through JV. So where from you are getting? You are getting from pension post offices, and you are getting from RBI banks. So pink advice will come, and accordingly you will be doing that. So these two will be the guiding factor for appropriating the money under appropriation funds. That is under DRF and pension fund. So pension fund based on the attritions and the amount that is you are booking based on the debit scrolls you received. Yeah, any other?
Okay, so I think we'll wind up the session here.
Sorry, I could not contain that
updates will be there. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Any more queries, please, or shall we wind up the session? Okay, sir, we'll wind up the session here. On behalf of Sitara, I thank Sri K. Damodar Prasad for explaining in detail the budget processes, appropriation accounts, and excess grants, and also interacting with the participants and clearing various doubts. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Dear participants, tomorrow we have session on scrap management in Indian Railways. The speaker is Mr. P. Raghuram, ISA, Senior ISA, South Central Railway. The login time is 11 o'clock and then session starts at 11:30. Thank you all. Have a nice day.